In this video, we will show you how to upgrade your Windows 10 installation to Windows 11 using two different methods. Both of these methods do not require a use of a USB drive and are downloaded to your PC and upgraded in place. As with any major update, you should back up any data you need in case things do not go as planned. If the update works as expected, all your apps and data will be safe, but there are no guarantees. First step is to navigate to Windows Update on your Windows 10 installation. At this point, you may see a banner at the top saying your PC is ready for Windows 11. If you see this, then you're all set to update. If you do not see the banner, sometimes you just need to click on the check for updates and it will appear. If it does not, we will cover how to update your system later in the video. If you do have the banner, all that you need to do is click on Download and Install on the banner, and when the license terms pop up, choose Accept and Install. At this point, Windows will download and install the update. This can take a while, and this video has been sped up. I recommend grabbing something to drink while you wait. Once the update is downloaded and installed, you'll get a prompt to restart the computer. Go ahead and select Restart, and the installation process will continue. You may see your computer restart multiple times during the upgrade process. Just leave it going for a bit, and once done, you'll be at the login screen. This can take a little while. Just go ahead and log in, and you will see Windows 11 is now installed. Towards the end of this video, I will show you how to go back to Windows 10 if you decide you don't want to stay with Windows 11. Now, what do you do if there is no banner saying you are ready to upgrade to Windows 11? Well, there are a couple more steps, but it is almost as easy as the previous method. First, you'll want to use the PC Health Check app to make sure your computer is compatible with Windows 11. On your Windows 10 computer, type PC Health Check in the Windows search bar and select the app. It may go through a quick installation, and then you'll see this screen. Just click on the Check Now button and find out if your PC is compatible. I will not be covering how to upgrade if your PC is not compatible in this video. If your PC is compatible, then you're all set to proceed to the next step. Navigate to the Microsoft Windows 11 download site, and towards the top you'll see the Windows 11 Installation Assistant. Read the notes before you start the upgrade, and then click on Download Now. Once the file is downloaded, navigate to the location of the file and right-click and choose Run as Administrator. After a brief moment, you should be presented with the terms and conditions. Click on Accept and Install once you are ready to upgrade. At this point, Windows will download and install the upgrade. This can take some time. This video has been sped up considerably. Once finished, you will get a window that says it is ready and you can restart the computer. If you do not do anything, it will restart by itself after a 30-minute countdown. Click on Restart Now, and you'll be told you'll now be signed out of the computer and will continue upgrade process. Your computer may restart multiple times during this process, and this video has been sped up. Just leave it be and wait until the process is complete. After a little while, you should get the login screen. Once you log into your computer, it will go through a quick couple minute process to finish the installation, and you should then have Windows 11 installed. You are now ready to enjoy your new Windows 11. At this point, you have 10 days to decide if you want to go back to Windows 10. If you do want to go back, all you need to do is type into Windows search bar, "Go back to Windows 10," and select "Go back to Windows 10 system settings." Here you'll see the button to go back. Just click on that and choose a reason. It will ask if you would like to try updating Windows 11, and we can choose no thanks. You'll then get a message screen and you can choose next, then choose go back to Windows 10 on the next screen. And at this point, your computer will restart and proceed with the process of going back to Windows 10. If you found this video helpful, please consider hitting the like button. Thank you.